Okay, today we're out in the shop and we're working on three-bladed Whirligig propellers. I've shown how to make Whirligig hubs for propellers before, but it's usually a four-bladed propeller or a two-bladed propeller. And it's a simple math that you can use for anything from a two-blade up to a multi-blade propeller like this one. This is an eight-blade hub. And you're just really limited by the amount of material that you have to cut, because when you're cutting the slots, you're removing material. So in order to get more than about 5 or 6 blades, you need to have a bigger hub because you need more material. Otherwise, you're gonna be left with nothing. Okay, so I'm gonna lay out the way you do this. It's based on a circle being divided into 360 parts, 360 degrees. I'm gonna lay it out real easy, step by step, so you can do this to lay out your hubs from anywhere from three blade hubs to 10, 12 or more, just depending on how many you want. Pretty easy. Mostly I make round ones, so I just have, they're actually door hole saws. So the only thing you have to be careful on these, because the diameters, if you want a specific diameter hub, the diameter on these is for the outside because it's making a hole. You're using the donut metal. So it's quite a bit smaller, maybe almost 1/4 inch smaller than what's advertised on the outside. So that's what comes out. So I'll show you how to put these together. Most of these have about 1/4 inch drill bit pilot that slides in there, and then a cap that you tighten up, and I usually just put this in the vise to tighten it like this, then hand tighten it, and then back over to the drill press. See that? And then the wood I use, I find that get the smoothest cut with the least splintering is poplar. Poplar has a not much smell, and it's kind of a greenish colored wood, and it's a very sustainable wood. It grows fast. I find it's the best for hubs. Drill it down, and what I do is I have a mark here. You can see this little mark I made. I only want to go about halfway through the, well, 3/4 of the way through the wood. Because if you go all the way up in the wood, if you go all the way down to the end, besides scraping your table and dulling your blade, that hub is going to get stuck up in there. And then you practically have to disassemble it to knock it out, because it gets really tight in there with all the sawdust. So I go to the line, I go down to the line, and then that's enough to leave a hole to the other side. And then I flip it over and just finish the last little bit. And that way I have enough sticking out to get the hub off. So after I cut out a bunch of hubs, the next step is to mark the hub accurately for the cutting jig. And I'll show you how I divide a circle and make a diagram and a marking jig to cut the hubs accurately. Show you how I do that. By the way, one of the fun Whirligigs you can make with this three-bladed hub is the wind turbine. I have plans for the wind turbine. It's just a matter of cutting the three-blade hub and cutting some big long blades out like this. And these work really well. And I just use a nail for a bushing and for an axle, and these really spin easily in the lightest of breeze. They're a lot of fun. I'm starting with a clean sheet of paper. You can use notebook paper is fine, actually probably better, because you can use one of the lines to line up your protractor. The tools you need, you just need a straight edge. You don't have to have a triangle, just a straight edge. And you do need a protractor, just get a cheap protractor. Since circle has 360 degrees. And you want three blades. You just put the number of blades that you want and do this division. Circle has 360 degrees. You want three blades. You divide it. You can use a calculator. 120 degrees. So each blade has to be 120 degrees apart, exactly 120 degrees apart, for the blades to be even. So how do I do that? How do I get that number into the blade, into the Whirligig hub? It's pretty easy. So I'm just going to start with a line. This will be the first reference line. Just start with a line. I use about midway in the paper to give you room to work and draw a line into the middle of the paper. That's it. And all the line has to be just long enough to go from the center line of the protractor through the scale. So if you can see this now, there's the reference line. And most of these protractors go both ways, so you got to be careful that whenever you do this, you always go the same way. So that's the zero. See the zero in the inner scale. And then I'm going to mark the center point here. You can just stop the line. You can use the edge of the line if you want, but I'm going to mark the center point. All right. 120 degrees. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. All the way over. I'm going to put a dot as close as accurate. Remember, this is going to be what you use to mark all the blades that you make, all the hubs that you make. So if you build in an inaccuracy in this pattern, all your blades are going to be inaccurate. So there's the 120. There's the center point. A lot of these protractors have a hole there at the center point. This just has a line. So mark that on your first reference line. Then I'm just going to connect center point and the 120 degree point. I'm going to put the pencil point on the dot and move my straight edge against the pencil point for the most accuracy. Once I get it drawn, I'm going to extend it out here a little bit. And I'm reinforcing these lines just to make them easier to see. These lines are 120 degrees apart. So the first one, 120. So now I'm just going to go to the second one. That line I just drew, put the protractor. Now I'm going to put the zero point of the protractor, the center, and it's usually marked with it usually has a hole in it. This one has a line. Get that lined up as close as you can. Put the line on the zero. Also 180, we'll call it zero for this, because we're going to count another 120 all the way around here and put another dot at 120. Close as you can get it. Bring the straight edge over, put the pencil on the dot, move the straight edge against the dot, and go into the center. All right. That's it. You don't need this part. I should have probably drawn that to the just to start it at the edge. But now you can see that 120. Every angle, every line is 120 degrees apart. You can go and check it. Go and check it. Make sure your lines are 120 degrees apart. 120. Okay. That's what they look like. They're good. And you would do the same thing for four blades. It would be 90 degrees apart. And whatever, how many blades you want. Draw a little arc there and an arrow. That's 120 degrees. So now, how do I get that to the wood? Well, what I do is I take this diagram that I just made. I take the diagram and I glue it onto a little piece of wood, plywood, whatever, nice little flat, straight piece of wood. And then I take the drill press and I drill a quarter inch hole and I put a quarter inch pin. This can be a dowel, wood. I use metal, right? I use a metal dowel pin. Now this one I've marked for 6 blades. So that's why I have these little arrows on here. That's it. Every one of those arrows, every other mark, every other line. So that's 120 degrees. If each one of these is 60 for 6 blades, then 2 of them is 120. So at the arrows is where 120 degrees is. Now I take one of my blanks, and I usually sand these a little bit on the belt sander to get them just smooth so they'll take a pencil mark. And I push it on to my little jig. And doesn't matter where you start, but once you've made a mark, once you've made one mark like that, don't move it. It can't move anymore, because that's where your accuracy is. It starts with that mark. So first mark at the first 120. Rotate it around, second mark, 120, as accurate as you can get, as close as you can get it. I even have, sometimes I take a little straight edge to get the line perfectly straight, but you don't have to, because you're only going to use, you know, just enough line to so you can see it. You can see it real well when you put it on your cutting jig on the table saw. So once you've marked all your hubs that you want to cut, there'll be, of course, there'll be 3 marks, 3 blades. You don't actually cut where the marks are. They're just reference. That's all they are. The next step is to go over to the table saw. Oh, and by the way, since I make 3 blades hubs and 4 blades hubs, here's my 4 blade marking jib. Here's my setup for the table saw. I have in here a double stack of blades. I'm trying to shoot for a 3/16 slot. I have a bolt. That's a 1/4-20 bolt. The hole in the center is 1/4 inch. I've got these are the marks, ones with the marks on them. And I will hold this piece of wood flat to the table. It's not flat right now because of the bar. But I hold it flat to the table and go through the center hole. You could use a drill bit to get a mark, just to get a mark. Again, the hub edge is flat to the table. And I make a mark and drill through. And then I would take this. And the way I used to do it, would I put a nut on this and I would tighten the nut. And, you know, get it close. But then the line, I would put the line. Notice I didn't draw the line across the whole thing. So I put the line against the wood. Because on this wood, and this is a piece of just a sacrificial wood. It gets all chewed up as you go through it with the saw. That doesn't matter. It lasts a long time. Because you're always going through at the same place. But you see the line I drew? That line is on the center line of that hole. As long as you have a good visible line that you can use again and again. Because you're just going to turn that index mark to line up with the line every time you make a cut. You make your first cut there, rotate it in the same direction. I usually go backwards to the next. Make another cut, make another cut. I find my hubs, my blades, spin the best at about 35 degrees. So that's where I'm just setting. You can see the miter gauge. I don't know if you can see that. I have it set at about 35 degrees. It's not real critical. I devised a little trick so that I wouldn't have to you know, every time I do this, I would have to, you see how long this takes? Let's say you're doing, I got 8 of them lined up to do. If I had to take this loose every time, you know, I had a wrench to tighten it. This will work, and you can do it if you're only making one Whirligig. I could recommend this way. It's easy, quick and easy. But if you're making a lot, it takes a lot of time to unscrew the bolt, to twist it to the next mark, and then tighten it back up, double check it, yada yada. So I came up with this kind of quickie method. It's an old piece of hinge from a barn door hinge or something. I don't know. I found it. Find it laying around in the garage. Then I just bring the bolt out enough to get a solid screw thread on there. A couple of threads, enough to hold it snugly. And then I make a wedge. I have a wedge that I cut with a slot in it. This angle, I don't know, just you have to eyeball it. I don't know what the angle is. It's like 20 degrees or something. Do you see how that fits in there? So once I get the hub, lined up with the blade, and this is a little bit critical, you want the blade to go through the center at the edge of the round. So I'll show you what happens if you don't do that. You're gonna cut, it looks good on that side. When you flip it over, you see that it barely comes to the edge there? That's because this isn't at the very edge of the round part. It's biased in this direction. You can see how this side has more meat on it than this side. So it looks, you won't get a good grip on the blades that way. It would probably work fine, but it's just not ideal. You have to get the hub centered on the blade so that it'll look even on as it goes through both sides. And for that reason, you might want to try, you know, a couple dummy, if you have some pieces that didn't come out too well, that have a knot in them, try a couple dummy pieces first before you try your perfect wood. I could show you the difference. Now here's one that's good. So this is the, I'll call this the front, and that looks good on both of them, doesn't it? But when you flip them over, you see the one on the left? That's because the blade did not go through the center. You see that the difference in the offset in the blade there, even though they're lined up. And this is what the result will be. It will look like this. So make sure when you're lining up the miter gauge. I have this clamp, just with a clamp. Slide this miter gauge back and forth until you get that blade where it looks like it's going to cut right through the center of the bolt, right? See that? And again, this is a tricky setup. One way you can do it is to take a straight edge and line the straight edge with the blade and see how it looks on top. It should go in the front an equal amount to where it comes out in the back. Line that up straight edge. You can use a piece of metal, sheet metal, any straight edge. That looks pretty good. So I've got my miter gauge extension lined up. I've got my bolt, my through bolt in, and it's catching at least 3 or 4 threads. Next thing I'm doing is I'm lining my mark, the reference mark we made with the jig, right there, exactly as close as you can get it every time. I have a line across the top that I drew with a square, carpenter square. So I can eyeball that line. Then once I get it lined up, I take my wedge, give it a whack, and that locks that thing in. That's great. So if it moves when you go through the saw blade, it's going to really distort and not fit the blade tightly. You don't want that to move. That's the first cut. Let's see what it looks like. Looks pretty good. That's one. You see the reference mark? The cut is opposite the reference mark, right? All right. Next step, I loosen my wedge, rotate this. I rotate it backwards. It doesn't matter as long as you always do them the same way. And you can do this with three, you can do it with six, seven, eight, ten. 10 blades, whatever. Make a windmill. All right, it's tight, it's lined up. Go for cut number two. Okay, rotating to the next index mark for cut number three. It's lined up, it's tightened up. Here we go, cut number three. All right, let's see what it looks like. Wedge out, loosen the bolt. Looks good. It looks real good. So I've only got six more to go. I'll be through for the day. The marks go towards the board.